Tilcon, New York. How you doing? Well, I hope everybody had a good week. So this week, we're going to talk a little bit about injury prevention. So injury prevention is not just about personal protective equipment. There's a lot of things that go on with it. We have Fit for Work that works for us with regards to stretching. So over the last few years, they've showed us a lot of stretching techniques. Now, I stretch before I perform physical activity in all kinds of sports. But there's certain things that you could do besides the stretching as well. It's relying on our senses, relying on our ears, hearing things. When I used to work as a plant operator in chemical manufacturing, I could actually tell when I got out of the car in the parking lot coming into work what equipment was running just by the sound. Also, you know, your odors, using your nose, tell if there's any unpleasant odors from that standpoint. We used to be able to do that with regards to chemical releases. And then obviously your eyes, you know, being able to see things, you know, regards if anything is actually wrong. So with that in mind, I want to talk a little bit about some of the jobs that I've done. And, you know, we kind of shared it before. But some of the things is that, you know, when I was working for a can manufacturer, when I was going around the plants, noticed a lot of guys had stubs of fingers. And what they would do is they'd put their hands into machines for tooling. And what regards to that is that they would not lock out the equipment, thus losing, you know, losing a digit. And then when I worked worked at the shipyard, there's a lot of guys performing hot work, welding, cutting. And what they would do is they'd walk around, they had pock marks all over their arms, which means that they weren't wearing the sleeves. So they had these little burn marks, which was rather disgusting. And then when I was, when I lived in Philadelphia for a short period of time, I lived in Center City. So I had the extreme pleasure of, you know, I do enjoy smoking a stogie once in a while. And it was the oldest cigar store in the United States, Holt's, in downtown Philadelphia. So I'd go over there and spend some time there. And I got to meet some of the older Philadelphia Eagles. I'm talking about guys that played in the late 50s and early 60s. And you know, got to talk to them, hear their experiences. And most of them had like gnarled fingers, just from being stepped on, just the collisions they had, the piles. And they just said it was just the cost of you know, playing professional football. So we don't want those type of things to happen to any of us. So let's talk about a little bit about injury prevention. So the things that I like to focus on with regards to, you know, injury prevention is there's three steps with regards to hazards. Hazard recognition that we kind of talked about. Hazard evaluation, how bad is that hazard? And how do we control those hazards? There's three types of ways that we control them. Engineering controls, administrative controls, and then last end would be personal protective equipment. So engineering controls are things like changing lighting, you know, putting better lighting in, ventilation, you know, adjusting the noise, putting in automation, and then temperature control. Those are the type of things that are engineering controls. Administrative controls are things like stress reduction, reducing noise, work rest periods, transferring jobs, you know, rotating jobs around. And then things like, you know, making sure we inspect our tools and equipment. And then, you know, education and training, making sure people are properly trained. And then once again, stretch programs. And then the last piece of this, and it's really truly the last piece, is personal protective equipment. All the pieces that we wear, high vis, hard hats, gloves, respiratory if necessary, you know, all those pieces, knee pads. I mean, it's important that we wear the personal protective equipment. First of all, that we have the right PPE and we're wearing it right, correctly. So there's just a few things that I want to talk about evaluating the hazards. Now, next week, here's a little you know, tip, if you will. Next week, we're going to be introducing a revised risk assessment form. And we'll go through that together. We'll talk about that together and how it could better the organization. So some of the things I want you to think about, you know, we talked about hazard rec. So let's talk about that evaluation. And I got just four examples here that I'm going to talk about. So there's situational risk. These are risks that are part of the job. Things that we know when we do these jobs, there's always going to be this potential. So what we have to do is these are the systemic risks, things that are there that have been taken a look at over surveys and taking a look at statistical and what they actually see as remedies. So let's just talk working in height. So you could fall, there's falling objects, there's injuries from sudden lifeline arrest if your fall protection system doesn't work. And then there's certain things here that turn up all the time in incident reports. Heavy equipment operation, there's crushing risk. You know, electrical shock, struck by debris or struck by an equipment part. And then what the systemic risks are associated with that. Hazardous terrain. I mean, there's pieces that go along with that. Faulty equipment. Construction. Men and women that are working out on the construction field, on the roadways. The situational risk, flagging, struck by vehicles, crushing risk in between the equipment when they're backing up, in between those all the equipment that they have. And then some of that is low visibility, the terrain dangers, lack of workplace awareness. I mean, those are things that are systemic risks that we have to take a look at and make sure we got the proper procedures and we do the proper training. And then finally, for our electricians, our electrical crew, there's electrocution, obviously, arc flash, machine energization, explosions, struck by equipment. I mean, those are the things that they need to take a look at. And then obviously, not having the proper personal protective equipment, having improper electrical preparation, not preparing in order when they open up those, open up pieces of equipment. So that's really important to make sure that everybody's taking a look at the risk, the hazard part of it, and then what are we doing with the hazard control? And that's what we're going to be working on as we go forward. So, with all that being said, well, as I mentioned, next week, we're going to be talking about a revised risk assessment form. So, with regards to that, Tilcon, New York, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay strong. Thank you, and have a safe week.